The Portland Trailblazers have made the playoffs for the past 8 seasons, the longest active stretch in the NBA, but that streak appears to be coming to an end. The Trailblazers' chance of making the playoffs are limited at this time, since they are 25-34 and the 10th seed in the Western Conference. They still have the chance to qualify for the play-in event, but it appears that they're fine with tanking for the rest of the season. Damian Lillard has only played in 29 games this season after undergoing abdominal surgery, and the Trailblazers are rebuilding for future success after moving CJ McCollum, Norman Powell, and Robert Covington before the trade deadline. On Wednesday, the team announced that their starting center, Joseph Nurkic, will miss the rest of the season due to left foot plantar fasciitis, which could lead to speculation about whether he has played his final game in a Portland Trailblazers uniform, as the Bosnian big man is set to become an unrestricted free agent this offseason. The Trailblazers' 2021-2022 season was a disaster for all the wrong reasons, and they will now enter the summer with the goal of getting Damian Lillard as much aid as possible. The first item of business for Portland would be to sign Anfernee Simmons to a large contract extension, but they will also be looking for ways to add additional star-like quality to their squad around Dame. They will enter the offseason with a salary of little more than $100 million, allowing them to add another max contract player to their roster. Ingles and Nurkic have expiring contracts and they will most certainly waive Eric Bledsoe, who will cost them around $3.9 million, owing to a partially guaranteed clause for the 2023 season. Portland will have plenty of opportunities to tinker with their squad in the offseason in order to rebuild it into a Western Conference competing force. Assuming Damian Lillard returns to the Blazers, they may attempt to sign one of the following players in the offseason to provide all-stars with the assistance he requires. In the number 3 spot, we have the Pistons' Jerami Grant. Grant was one of the top players on the market heading into the trade deadline this season, attracting a lot of attention. The Trailblazers were heavily involved in the Grant trade with the Pistons prior to the deadline, but they were unable to reach an agreement. Grant would be in the final year of his contract with the Pistons entering the offseason, and many in the league believe that Detroit will attempt to leverage him ahead of the 2022 NBA draft in order to acquire more first-round picks. Portland's interest in Jerami Grant is obvious, which is why they may eventually attempt to acquire him in a trade. The Pistons have already expressed interest in Josh Hart, and he might be a crucial selling point in trade talks with the Trailblazers this offseason. Grant has developed into one of the league's best two-way combo forwards since joining the Pistons ahead of the 2019-2020 season. Grant has averaged 21.1 points, 4.5 rebounds, 2.7 assists, and 42.4% from the field in 87 games with the Pistons. He would be a great fit on the wing in Portland, where he'd be a significant backup scoring option with Damian Lillard and Anfernee Simmons. Portland's alleged interest in Jerami Grant hasn't gone away this season, and the fact that he'll be entering his final year of the deal in the offseason should make the Trailblazers even more interested in the 27-year-old forward. In the number 2 spot, we have the Pelicans' Zion Williamson. Williamson was meant to be the savior of the Pelicans club, and many projected him to be the next best player in the NBA after LeBron James. It might still happen, but it appears that his time in New Orleans is coming to an end. Zion is yet to make his season debut after suffering a fractured foot in the offseason and undergoing surgery. There appears to be some animosity between the young All-Star and the New Orleans executive office. If things don't work out, Zion Williamson could be the best player available on the trade market this offseason. Even if there are questions about his injury history and long-term durability, Portland would be silly not to pursue him. Because the two sides made a large transaction involving CJ McCollum at the trade deadline, who they would offer to New Orleans would be a major concern, but Portland possesses draft picks and could get a third or fourth club involved to acquire the Pelicans another win-now piece in place of Zion. Throughout the teaming Zion Williamson with Damian Lillard has to be appealing to the Portland Trailblazers at this point in time, it's even more intriguing considering Zion has been rehabbing in the Portland area. Given his familiarity with the area and his recovery in Portland, it would make sense for Zion Williamson to desire to join the Trailblazers if he requested a trade. And finally, in the number 1 spot, we have the Indiana Pacers' Miles Turner. The Trailblazers expressed interest in trading for Pacers big man Miles Turner before the trade deadline this season. Turner, on the other hand, experienced a stress response in his left foot about a week before the deadline, forcing many clubs, including the Trailblazers, to shift their focus elsewhere. Miles Turner, the only other 25-year-old, is already one of the league's finest shot-blocking big men. Turner ranks second in the league in blocked shots, And since the 2015 season, following the only Jazz big man, Rudy Gobert, who had 1,089. Miles Turner was leading the NBA in block shots per game until hurting his foot this season, and he has led the league in blocks of two of the last three seasons. With only 1 year remaining on his contract after the season, Indiana Pacers may be willing to let Turner go, especially considering that they have Isaiah Jackson, Goga Bitadze, and Jalen Smith in their front court. Joseph Nurkic would be a great free agent for the Blazers this offseason, and with him expected to command a salary of up to $16 million per year, Portland could simply sign Miles Turner for $18 million next season, saving up to $16 million per year, and Portland could simply sign Miles Turner for $18 million next season, saving them even more money in the long run and potentially pursuing other avenues at the center position. Well guys, thank you so much for making it to the end of the video. Be sure to smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and ring that notification bell so you never miss a video. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.